confirmed what appears to be a building explosion and fire at the intersection of Hughes and 3rd.
Roger, 734. Additional units and fire are en route. Fire will provide incident command. I'm patching your body cam feed to command now.
Roger, dispatch.
What do we have, Sarge?
Pretty much what the 911 caller reported. Looks like a building explosion.
Fire command is set up one block over. Williams and Moore over there.
Audrey, patch this call to Corporal Williams on his radio.
Copy that, Sergeant Parker. Patching you to Corporal Williams, located two blocks east on 3rd Avenue.
Williams.
Corporal, this is Sergeant Parker.
Go, Sarge.
You've got incident command setting up over there where you are. I need you to reroute traffic and keep onlookers way back so fire and EMS can get through.
Roger, already on it.
Sarge, check your phone, we got an alert.
Audrey, give me incident command. Any path.
Linked to incident command.
Command, this is Sergeant Parker.
Battalion Chief Bender here, Sergeant. I see you're on the northwest corner. From your video, it looks like the building entrance is blocked with debris.
It's going to take some digging to get inside.
We're linked to the closed circuit cameras in the building. We also have a drone up overhead showing two large hotspots on the top floor. But a witness says there are at least two people still in the building, so I'm sending a team to the 3rd Street entrance.
I've got two civilians here. Who's in trouble?
Fire Team 1, it looks like we have a mayday. Firefighter Thompson is down. Heart and breathing rate spiking.
We're on it, Chief. Got pinned by a chunk of ceiling. We're also bringing out two civilians. We put vital sensors on them. EMS should be getting readings now.
EMS, do you copy the message from Fire Team 1?
Got it, Chief. I'm getting vital signs on one firefighter, two civilians.
Looks like we have two red tag patients with severe burns and trouble breathing, and a firefighter with possible crush injury. I need you to start the IV and get ready to intubate. Audrey, connect me to the nearest trauma center.
Linking to St. Anthony's Trauma Center, 3.7 miles. Estimated travel time, 7 minutes.
This is Miriam Zhang. Go ahead, EMS.
I have three victims, two civilians, one firefighter. I don't have eyes on them yet, but I'm sending you telemetry.
Yes, I see the data. Definitely two red tags there. Do you have RSI medications ready and prepared to intubate if needed?
We do. As soon as we get them stabilized and we're on the way, I'll send more telemetry and detailed assessment information.
Okay, we'll be ready. Thanks for the heads up. I'll continue monitoring their vitals and transport.
Audrey, patch me to command.
This is command. Go, EMS.
Chief, we have two victims in serious, maybe critical condition. I'm recommending a medevac.
Copy that. I'll alert aviation. There's a park two blocks east of here. Looks like the best landing site. I'll have law enforcement coordinate off.
I have the view from a camera on a building across the street. It looks under control.
I have a white SUV matching the description on two traffic cams, headed east on 3rd past Tacony. I think I can pull the plate number from them.
Okay, great work. Let's data cast the route that vehicle's on to all patrol units, and when we get the plate number, let's send that out as well.
Good job, Sarge.
First responders today have nothing like the communications tools in this video, but we are making progress. Through its Next Generation First Responder program, the DHS Science and Technology Directorate is leading the effort to develop these capabilities and get them into the hands of responders in the next 5 years. It's important work that will help law enforcement, fire, and emergency medical personnel save lives, protect property, and enhance security in communities everywhere.